Hello everyone, I'm Chen Bingpeng from Nanjing University. My advisor is Professor Bing Mao. This work is finished when I visited Stevens Institute of Technology under the supervision of Professor Jun Xu and Professor Eric Koskinny. It's my honor to present our SoK work on all you ever wanted to know about x86 and x64 binary disassembly, but were afraid to ask. It's a joint work by Rutong Yu from Stevens Institute of Technology, Yohui Chen from Facebook, Eric Koskinny, Georgios Polycalides, and Jun Xu from Stevens Institute of Technology, and Bill Mo from Nanjing University. In practice, we do not have access to the source code of many software systems, such as commercial software, legacy software, and third-party software. However, not surprisingly, such software systems also contain vulnerabilities, and we definitely need to provide mitigations against those vulnerabilities. When you have source code, you can analyze their syntax, grammar, and semantics by converting the source code to abstract syntax tree or control flow graph. And all the code, functions, and execution flows are available for you. With the help of this information, you can perform all kinds of analysis or make changes as needed by using the infrastructure of compiler. However, when you only have binary code, literally, you only have a sequence of zero one bits, and it is only readable for machine. You have no syntax, no grammar, no semantics, no code, no functions, no execution flows, and so on. In order to analyze the binary code, we need to recover more structured information from the sequence of 0-1 bits. That's what binary disassembly does. Binary disassembly is a task that translates the binary code to assembly language, which is the inverse operation to that of an assembler. More specifically, binary disassemblers recover instructions firstly and then mark the function entry at specific location. Furthermore, some disassemblers reconstruct the execution flows to better analyze the binary code. With the help of binary disassembly, we could apply various security measures to add binary code. That is to say, binary disassembly is the foundation of mitigating vulnerabilities in binary code. Binary disassembly has seen remarkable advancements in the past 20 years, awarding researchers and developers with a variety of tools and frameworks, and both open source and commercial license. When you want to do binary disassembly, you have so many choices, but which tools to use? In order to answer this question, we present this SoK work. Specifically, we want to answer the following two questions. The first one is how do the tools work, and the second one is how well do the tools perform. To answer the first question, we need to learn the details of disassemblers. To achieve this goal, we could read the documentation and papers of the targeted disassemblers, or search corresponding blogs from web, extract incomplete technical details among comments, questions, and even debates from forum. However, some of the documentation, papers, blogs, or discussions are missing or incomplete. Moreover, due to the rapid development of actively maintained tools, some of the descriptions from web or documentation are out of date. So it is very hard for us to learn the technical details from what's mentioned above. To better understand the details of implementation in open source disassemblers, we choose the distinct but effective way to read their source code. Specifically, we download the source code from their website or GitHub, read their source code, and summarize the strategies used by these tools. After reading their source code and summarize their strategies used to disassemble, we know how the tools work. Specifically, we focus on following four tasks: recover instructions, functions, execution flows, and pointers. And we summarize their strategies into two categories, algorithms and heuristics. Algorithms typically produce results with some correctness guarantees. They mostly leverage knowledge from binary or use convincing analysis, such as value set analysis. Heuristics are based on common patterns, for example, summarize signatures of function stars. These strategies do not offer assurance of correctness. The red part shows the result of our summary. Numbered with rings means that the strategies are algorithms. Numbered with disks means that the strategies are heuristics. We do not show the details in this presentation. If you are interested, welcome to read our paper. In summary, we found that there are 15 principal algorithm strategies which could guarantee the correctness in theory, and 29 heuristics which do not offer any guarantee. Through this way, we answered question 1. How the tools work. Next, I'm going to share some interesting findings when we survey these tools. The first finding is that some tools combine recursive disassembly and linear sweep disassembly. As we know, linear sweep disassembly continuously scans preselected code ranges and disassembles each instruction one by one. That leads to high coverage, but it may scan all the data in code and disassemble them, so it causes low precision. In contrast, recursive disassembly starts with a given code address and disassembles instructions following the control flow. That leads to high precision, but some complex structures such as function start, jump tables, and exactly make the coverage low. We found that Angular combines recursive disassembly and linear sweep disassembly together, tries to disassemble the code with high coverage and high precision. Specifically, it starts recursive disassembly firstly and tries to scan the possible instructions among the gaps left after recursive disassembly. The next finding is that some tools leverage exception information to identify function entry. To support the exception handling, the compiler generates the unwinding table into binary by default according to the systemd ABI. With this example, I'll show how exception handling handled with the help of unwinding table. In this example, when the program executes at line 3, it throws an exception. To find the proper exception handler, it needs to work the call frames and check if current frame contains proper exception handler meanwhile. It is worth noting that the ABI utilizes unwinding table to work the call frames. Specifically, every function has a corresponding entry in the unwinding table, and PC start and PC range are included in each entry, which represent the function start and the function size. So the exception information gives the clue of function entry, and Gedra and Angular leverage this information to mark the possible function start. The last finding I'm going to present is the conditional nonreturn function. Nonreturn function is the function that terminates execution at runtime. As the compilers know which function is nonreturn function, compilers do not insert first row edge after calling nonreturn function. In this example, the left part shows the ground truth. In line 2, it calls nonreturn function error, and there is no first row edge between line 2 and line 3. However, if the disassembler can't identify the nonreturn function at line 2, the recursive disassembler will disassemble the following instructions after line 3 which are byte instructions. So it is important to identify narrative functions when disassembling. And we found one interesting category of narrative function, conditional narrative. For example, for arrow and arrow at line function, their first parameter is status. It is an integer type. When the value is zero, it prints error message to standard error. And when the value is non-zero, it prints error message to standard error first and then coexist with value of status. That means these functions are not return function or not, depending on the value of their arguments. And we found that all the disassemblers we surveyed do not handle this kind of non-return functions correctly. To answer the second question, we do a large evaluation. Firstly, we built about 4,000 binaries from scratch. These binaries include programs and libraries of diverse functionality and complexity, writing in C or C++, and containing handwriting, assembly, and hand-coded binary code. To obtain the ground truth automatically, we trace the compilation step by step and collect necessary information into binaries. Lastly, we evaluate each tool and strategy separately. For every task, we show the results in three aspects. The first is overall result. We show the coverage and accuracy of each tool as a whole in this part. The next is dissected result. As we know every strategy used in each tool, so we also present the coverage and accuracy contributed by each strategy. The last aspect is analysis of errors. In this part, we analyze errors of each tool introduced by each strategy. For these evaluation results, we answer the question 2. We know performance of each disassembler. You can not only know overall results from our evaluation, but also learn more detailed results. In this example, sub figure A is the evaluation result from using Security 16 about instruction recovery. It only shows the overall result. In our evaluation, we not only present overall result as shown in subfigure B, but also shows the result of instruction recovery without heuristics. From those results, you can conclude more detailed information, such as how many instructions are introduced by heuristic strategies. In our evaluation, we found that every tool makes mistakes more or less in every task. That is because the disassemblers use many heuristic strategies to reach high coverage. There exists a trade-off between high accuracy and high coverage. Now we can learn the following lessons from our work. The first is every tool misses cases or makes mistakes in each task. That is to say, nothing is perfect. The second is principled algorithms and heuristics compared for coverage and accuracy. That is a trade-off. Today's binary disassembly falls short for vulnerability mitigations. At the end, we would appreciate Vector's Certified Inc. for providing us free lessons of Binary Ninja after reading our paper. Thanks. Thank you for listening. I'm ready to answer the questions.